Hello friends, welcome to Civil Fit. Today we are going to see about well hydraulics in geotechnical engineering. Now we are going to see about the aquifer, aquiclude, aquiquage and aquiter. Most of the students confuse these four topics. We can expect the questions from this topic in many of the competitive exams. First we are going to see about the aquifer. Aquifer means it is the permeable formation. That means it can allow the water to pass through and it contains the water. Aquiclude means it contains water but it cannot allow the water to pass through, like tar material. Aquifuge means it cannot contain water and it cannot transmit water. Aquitar means it is a semi-permeable membrane. Only a seepage of water occurs. It does not contain waters. Now we are going to see the difference. It is a permeable formation. Aquiclude is an impermeable formation. Aquifuge is an impermeable formation. Aquitar is a semi-impermeable formation. Aquifer allows the flow of appreciable quantity of water. Aquiclude means it contains water but not capable of transmitting water. Aquifuge means neither contains water nor transmit water. Aquitar means it allows only the flow of seepage water. This is the question which is asked in TNPSC AE 2019. The question is, an impermeable formation that neither contains nor transmit water is called. The answer is aquifuge. We already know aquifer is a permeable formation, aquiclude is a permeable formation but it allows the water to pass through. Aquifuge is an answer and aquitar is only allows the seepage flow of water. Now we are going to see about the specific yield and the specific retention. To explain the specific yield and specific retention, have taken the volume of soil of 10 meter cube here, and I have considered among this 10 meter cube of volume of soil, 3 meter cube is volume of voids. To calculate the specific yield and specific retention, the quantity of volume of voids plays the major role. Among this 3 meter cube of volume of voids, I have going to calculate the volume of water drained by gravity and volume of water retained. For example, I have considered among this 3 meter cube of volume of voids, the amount of water retained by gravity is 1. Means to calculate the volume of water retained, we need to subtract 3 minus 1 so that we can get volume of water retained. The formula to calculate the specific yield is volume of water drained by gravity divided by total volume. The specific retention means volume of water retained divided by total volume. If the volume of water drained by gravity is 1, means the specific yield is 1 by 10. For specific retention, that means here 1 by 10 means 3 minus 1, 2. So 2 by 10. Then the specific capacity means discharge from well per unit drawdown. Specific storage is defined as storage coefficient divided by unit depth of the confined aquifer. I repeat, specific storage is defined as the ratio of the storage coefficient to the unit depth of the confined aquifer. Water table drops by 3 meter in irrigable land of 50 hectare. If the porosity and specific retention are 0.30 and 0.10 respectively, the change in the storage in hectare meter is. We already know volume is equal to area into depth. In question itself they had said area is 50 hectare and the water table, that is depth, is 3 meter. So 50 into 3 we get the volume as 150 hectare meter. We already know this notation, that is specific yield, the specific retention equal to porosity. Specific retention and porosity is given in the question itself. By using these two values, we can calculate the specific yield, that is 0.30 minus 0.10, that is 0.20. We already know specific yield is defined as volume of water drained by gravity or change in the storage divided by total volume. That is, we already know here specific yield 0.20, the total volume 30. By substituting these two values, we can get the change in the storage in hectare meter, that is 30 hectare meter. Thank you for watching our video. For more video, subscribe my channel